everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end. And also, if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a topic that is TTM revenue to LTM revenue. So at the very first end, what we can see over here is a screenshot of LTM of the last year, of the last 12 years, and so on and so forth. The most recent period, the period prior to one, period ending 1 year prior to the most recent one. So let's understand what this thing is all about. See, what is TTM revenue, LTM revenue? At the end of the day, LTM revenue is basically interesting concept, and every investor should look at how exactly it works. See, LTM over here, it stands for, it means the last 12 months. So this last 12 months revenue, the last 12 months revenue is known as, is called as your TTM revenue, which is also known as your trailing 12 month or 12 months revenue, right? TTM. So you must have got LTM means the last 12 months revenue, and TTM means the trailing 12 months revenue. Now, when an investor wants to understand how a firm is doing financially, he or she uses the LTM ratio or the LTM revenue as a measurement. And in most cases, firms prepare their financial report for past 12 months, which is usually 12 months, you can say that. And the LTM revenue or the TTM revenue helps us to look at the profit for the whole year instead of just having a brief glance on the quarterly profit. Now, what is good? Is it the LTM revenue or the quarterly revenue? LTM or quarterly revenue? What is good? Now, my one single question. Now, which is better for financial analysis? Let's understand this by taking an example. Let's say the company, there's a company called Prince Toys Limited. And it has some following information as TTM revenue standing at, let's say, $4 lakh. They have some quarterly revenue, let's say, standing at $92,000. So if an investor, we just look at the last quarter for the two quarters, we would get a recent figure. But the point is, by looking at the recent figures, you are skipping the important consideration. So by looking at the quarterly revenue, you are not able to judge, whether the company has earned that revenue due to the seasonal reasons. So it may so happen that due to the festive seasons, the firm firm has sold more toys than the rest of the year. So on the other hand, it may say sell fewer toys due to the labor problems, strikes, etc. So as an investor, to understand a company's financial health, you need to look at holistically and you cannot look at partially. So that's why understanding the TTM revenue is more important than the quarterly revenue. I hope I have made you understand the importance. Now let's calculate the TTM revenue. If you are a finance junkie, it would be quite easy for you. For an investor who have just started out, the method would be useful to you on two bases. First, you would be able to calculate the LTM revenue of any year of any firm. Second, you will be able to compare the LTM revenue of the same or the different firms whenever you get the figure. Let's look at the method of calculating the LTM. Now, let's say there's an ice cream company which has some following details of 2016 and 2017. Let's say from July to September, it has some following details like $50,000. From October to December, this is basically the revenue details, $62,000. And from January to March, considering as the calendar year, $54,000. And April to June, let's say $49,000. And July to September as $57,000. I'll quickly write Jan to March. April to June and July to September, right? So this are the details that we have. Okay, we have to Jan to March. So find out the LTM revenue for 2016 and 2017. For June 2016 and for September 2016. Now all we need to do is to add up the quarterly revenue. So we'll first calculate the TTM revenue for 2016. For calculating the TTM revenue for 2016, we need to add the July to September and October to December. So we'll add up we need to add up the July to September, October to December, January to March, and April to June. Here's the calculation: 50,000 plus 62,000 plus 54 plus 49. So that's 215,000. Now we'll calculate the TTM revenue for September 2016. That was for June 2016. Now we are going to calculate for September 2016. Now this is TTM. Now for calculating the TTM for September 2016, we need to add from October to December this value. Or we'll just start adding up. So October to December, 62,000 plus 54 plus 49 plus 57,000, which comes to $222,000. So calculating the last 12 months revenue from June 2016 and September 2016 have served a purpose. As an investor, you can now look at the quarterly revenues holistically and not periodically. Now, since the LTM revenues average out the seasonal changes, if any, from the quarterly revenue, as a result of LTM and TTM revenue provides more clarity to the investor before they ever get interested to invest in the company. So even the balance sheet does not get affected by the last 12 months revenue. So the balance sheet is prepared at a single point of time, no matter what happens throughout the year. Now we'll understand the use of this particular formula. What exactly is the use, which is really important. Now, why investor and financial analysts use the LTM revenue? Revenue, here's a small list. See, the last 12 months revenue is considered more recent than the annual reports. Okay. Now, if the investor looks at the annual report in the mid of the next year, he or she would only understand what happens that during the year last year. As a result, the first 6 months of the year will be skipped, but if he or she calculates LTM revenue, they would get the most recent figure of the company. Second, the short-term measurement don't serve investor and financial analyst revenue for the immediate year and may not be a big chunk of time, but it serves a purpose. Third, the financial analyst prefers the TTM revenue because while acquisition, TTM revenue provides the most accurate valuation of the business. Fourth, the last 12 months revenue allows the investor to allow the investors to basically compare the relative performance similar companies under the same industry.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.